Hi, it's day 18, and I bring to you this morning, as I have done over the last 17 days, a scripture that God has laid on my heart. This particular scripture is one of the most comforting and reassuring in the Bible, and I pray it will bless you. I want to encourage you to receive it, meditate on it, confess it, make a declaration around it, and believe that it will bear fruit in your life. It is the Word of God. The scripture for today is taken from the book of Isaiah, the 43rd chapter of the book of Isaiah, Isaiah 43 and the second verse, Isaiah 43 verse 2. And this is what the Bible says. When you go through deep waters, I will be with you. When you go through rivers of difficulty, you will not drown. When you walk through the fire of oppression, you will not be burned up. The flames will not consume you. The scripture paints a picture of life. Sometimes we find ourselves in deep waters. Sometimes we ask ourselves, how on earth did we get into these deep waters? And sometimes we don't swim as well as we could or should or can in deep waters. We're struggling. Like someone who finds themselves naturally in deep waters, we don't want to drown. And sometimes we face rivers of difficulty. It looks like the tide is against you. You're trying to swim against the tide, but the tide seems to have got the better of you. It's either kept you stationary, or worse still, it's pushing you back in a direction that you don't want to go. And there are many difficulties we encounter in life that actually are like that person that is swimming against the tide. And sometimes we find ourselves in flames. Sometimes, and I'm sure I'm talking to someone who's out there, you are in a hot place. It seems like it's burning. It is deeply uncomfortable, maybe even painful. But guess what? The scripture brings an assurance to us. In deep waters, God will be with us. He will take us through rivers of difficulty. He will be like that fourth man in the fire so that we go through the flames, but the flames won't consume us. I also pray that it's not just that the flames won't consume you. You'll come out at the other end and your clothes won't be scorched at all from the flames because he has surrounded you with his protection. And so I want to believe that God is sending this scripture as his word. I want to ask the Spirit of God to breathe upon this word so that it's not just the Logos, the written word of God. It has become a rhema. It's come alive for someone who's out there today. And you receive it into your heart as a word from God. And so why don't you join with me as I join my faith with yours to believe that this word will bear fruit, that our Father in heaven will cause this word to come alive in your life and to bear fruit, tangible fruit from which you will give a testimony. So can we pray together? Heavenly Father, I just want to thank you for your word. It is comforting, it is reassuring, and today it brings encouragement to my brother or my sister who is watching at this point in time. Heavenly Father, exactly as your word says, my sister or my brother is going through a very challenging time, going through a difficulty. They are in deep waters. They are wondering how they can get out of it. I actually feel very strongly in my spirit now that I'm speaking to someone who has something legal that they are dealing with. And it's threatening to drown you. You're in deep waters legally, perhaps a case or something legal. You've exhausted all your options. Well, the Lord says I should let you know that he's taking you out of those deep waters to the glory of his name. And you're facing the rivers of difficulty of any kind. Well, God wants me to tell you by his word that he's taking you through those rivers of difficulty. The rivers, you will not drown in them. You're in a place where the heat is intense, the heat of circumstances, the heat of challenges, the heat of difficulties. You're at a place where you can feel the flames. They are coming closer and closer. And you even have some fear because you're wondering how you will get through this challenging circumstances. I want you to know that the word of God has come to you today to assure you that God is going to ensure that those flames don't consume you. What a reassuring word. Father, we thank you for it as we receive it, Heavenly Father. So my brother and my sister, receive this as a word from God. Make it a confession. Make it a declaration. Why don't you even make it a decree? Because you have received it as the word of the Lord. And decree that I will not drown in those deep waters. I will certainly not be overcome by the rivers of difficulty. And irrespective of the intensity of the flames, I am going through because the Lord himself has said so. God bless you.